Whoa.
What you call an icon living? Start a record label, Miss Fish just did it. All your verses sound like dirty dishes.
Grow up.
I am as an icon living. Start a record label, Miss Fish just did it. Then we can chill and look at the view. Damn.
It's your boy, Willie B. We got an OG. We're going out west. 1990. Fella by the name of Ice Cube. You know, a lot of people might know him nowadays from he's in movies. If you know Ice Cube, he's always been hip-hop. N.W.A. came out in 86, and you all know that cast. I think most people know him from the Straight Outta Compton album back at this time. This is before he got into his first movie, which was The Boys in the Hood, because he met, you know, John Singleton knew about, you know, N.W.A. and knew about Cube's, you know, talent, and he thought he was perfect for the role of Doughboy. And that took his career to a whole nother trajectory. But the album we're covering today is America's Most Wanted. So that came out like 2 years before he even graced the big screen. He's so talented. He's a writer, rapper, director. He could just do it all. Born South Central, Los Angeles. I didn't know that Cube converted to being a Muslim that early. I really didn't even know he was a Muslim, to be honest. Because he never really repped it. He never really wore the kufis. Really, the Muslims was the only group of black people that were really unified. That's really why a lot of black people decided to join. Because it's like, shit, whatever organization is that unified of all black people. I think his big pop on the scene was the No Vaseline record. And when him and N.W.A. split, that's when he really started going at pretty much everybody. So this is definitely going to be a gangsta rap night. I love gangsta rap when it's done right. You know what we're doing on this side. I think my favorite Cube movie, Barbershop. That might be the one. And they did two Barbershop. Barbershop, let me give him Barbershop. You got to see a little range. He had to play serious and slightly comedic sometimes.
I heard payback's a breath on the trigger. That's why I'm sick of getting treated like another damn stepchild. Kill punk because I ain't him. You got to deal with the 9-double.
I like the way it just throws you right into it. You kind of feel like you just catching this nigga mid-transit. You just hopping in his car as it's still riding. I like that. There's something jiggy about that beat. It's two different distinct samples that they slapping together, but it feels really good. Yeah, this was cool. I've always liked it when rappers do a beat that's just always transitioning. It's like kind of a different beat every few measures. I always liked that. Really gave me the idea. I think I'm going to do that. Just pick a few of my favorite beats and just have them switch every like four bars type of deal. I like it. I like this first song. It got me in the groove. You're in the action.
Oh, okay.
This beat is interesting. It's got jazz drums on it. Not like a West Coast beat. This feels very New Yorkish. And I just found out that, you know, Public Enemy's producing squad is behind this. So now it makes sense because I think Cube was off some, all right, I'm West Coast and I'm going to put the vibes in there, but I want East Coast to recognize this shit in it. He said a lot in that record. Another record that's got, you know, a bunch of transitions in it. I like it. Some of the transitions I didn't care for. But when they bring it back, you know, and he does his thing, he's just talking about committing crimes, being young and trying to figure out how to get money. You know, you're young and you see you want the money. You don't know how to do it. You don't know how to get it. So the people around you, you see them selling dope. You see them robbing. You see them stealing. And they come around you with new shit all the time. And then you want to go get into that life. So he's kind of explaining just fucking hood rat crime life.
Getting down in the crack game, fools think I'm soft. Cause now I'm in the rap game, man, I don't hang out as much. Hang out, don't touch. Standing on stage and I'm grabbing my nuts.
Who the fuck is Little Joe? We gotta honker this down, cause literally this is probably the third or fourth record I've heard him say Little Joe. He's in one of his most popular records, if you remember.
7-Eleven, 7-Even back door, Little Joe.
Always talking about Lil Joe. We gotta get to the bottom of it.
Alcohol is filling up my bladder. What's the date and time? It don't matter. I had a pocket full of phone numbers. I was trying to sort to make a long story short.
Them West Coast niggas, they did not give a fuck. They will literally say any damn thing on the record. You should not take this advice. This is a young Ice Cube. This nigga's talking out the side of his head. Do not do this. Cube, you wild, nigga. What the hell? You don't just kick her in. Y'all was ruthless. Y'all was on that NWA shit hard. Y'all was like, fuck bitches, get money for real. This is like the hood abortion song. He's telling you all the crafty hood ways to fucking get you to commence an abortion procedure. He's telling you everything you need to know. Do not listen to this nigga, okay? You say a coat hanger, huh, Q? I got many of them. I kind of like the beat, though. So the baby made it. He didn't kill the baby. He wasn't successful with the hood tactics. So the baby made it. And he said, damn, this baby look like my neighbor. How the baby look like the neighbor, dog? Like, you know that already. You know babies look crazy as hell when they first come out. He said, nah, that look like Jimmy next door, don't it? He said, damn, I should have killed her. This is wild as a motherfucker, Cube. I know Cube looked back at, I know he hid this shit from his kid. That's why he tried to do so many Family Man movies, because of this shit right here.
Once upon a time in a project, yeah, I damn near had to wreck the hoe. I knocked on the door. It's Ice Cube.
Listening to Ice Cube, you know, I covered Too Short, and Too Short got to be the most foulest mouth motherfucker I've ever heard. The most I don't give a fuck motherfucker ever. But this right here, he's coming up at a strong two. He just telling it raw, ugly. He's saying it foul. It ain't meant, it's meant to make you feel a way. Either you fuck with it or you like, you gonna feel the way. Like, that's his music. It, you know, and that's Too Short too. All of these niggas. That's gangster music really at its essence, you know. Because they're not saying bullshit stories. They're saying the truth, you know. But the truth sometimes is ugly and it's delivered ugly. He paints the picture for you. You can be there. You might not like what you're seeing, but you there.
Be the oldest and the newest creatures added to the endangered species list. As of now, the government has not made steps to preserve the blacks. When asked why, a top law official adds, because they make good game.
Yeah, I like this beat. This sounds like some shit that Public Enemy would do for sure. Definitely got that type of spaz to it. And it's just wild how they pull elements from other shit but just make it its own. Chuck D pops up just out of thin air. We knew it. Felt like it was too dope of a fucking Public Enemy type vibe for Chuck to not want to get a taste of that. I really like the song. You know, the message is very real. It's just talking about how, you know, young black teams are, young black people in general was always targeted. And always just, you know, it's always been this fight just to be free and live. This time was, this was a scary ass time just to be black. It still is, but like, this was super scary. You really feel what it's like when you being pressed by the police against your will, knowing that you innocent and you ain't do nothing, you just living and you getting pressed out by the police. I got pressed out by the police in front of my house. I'm like, nigga, you check my, I live right here.
You always teach stuff about the brawls and the suckers. Why don't you teach some stuff about the kids? The damn kids!
Little boys and girls, they all love me. Come sit on the lap of ICE. And let me tell you a story or two.
So this is tapping into one of my favorite, you know, styles of beats, which is New Jack Swing. And this definitely got that kick. I like this one. And this is like supposed to be for the kids. So I like that, you know, Cube did try. He was like, yo, I can make a little record for the kids. He gonna use the nursery rhyme characters and just make them the hood characters and tell the hood stories. So Cinderella a hoe and she's selling ass for the for Humpty Dumpty, I think. And Humpty and her do crack together. And somehow Mr. Rogers is in here. Mr. Rogers is, I think he pushing his own type of dope. It's crazy. It's wild as shit. But Humpty get upset because I think Mr. Rogers is like fucking his girl. Some shit. Once again, you see, still amaze me.
Man, put the PC up. You want to tell him to put a cap. Well, matter of fact, on the cover like you were over the
So he's shouting out the lynch mob heavy in this, and he shouted out Yo-Yo. Shout out to Yo-Yo, because Yo-Yo showed me love on my page too. So shout out to Yo-Yo. Cube definitely showing love. You know, he gotta show love. That's the squad. just a simple bass line. You know what I mean? You know I'm a sucker for a bass line. And Cube just know how to do it, man. Cube is so on pace with... He definitely know how to rap. When it comes to this rap shit, he put it down. I see why he's one of the godfathers of rap. I never heard early Cube, but he snaps. You know, he's like a slingshot. Yeah, that be dope. That's that old Cadillac music right there. You know what I mean? It's that old school Boosie Collins feel right there. You know what I mean? This the joint. You know, you're in a 6-4 with the dice in the mirror. This is definitely macadelic music. You know what I mean? It's something you can just throw on and vibe to for sure. I love this beat. Like, it's just the wooing, the macking. You know, even though she know it's trouble, but she still want to go to it.
Women, they good for nothing. I may be worth it to serve needs to my ding-a-ling. I'm a man who loves the one-night stand. Because after I do you...
It's a really good song. First of all, another shout-out to Yo Yo. Yo Yo come out. And it's good because, you know, it's a lot of male dominance on this album. And Cube is a genius, like always. So he gives the female voices. For Yo-Yo, she's a good female voice to come in and combat the male energy. He talking about it's a man's world, and she like, nigga, fuck you, you know? The fuck you talking about? Nigga, y'all would be shit without us. You came from us, all this shit. So Yo-Yo holding it down on the female side, and, you know, they just going back and forth. So this is, like, the perfect song. Good song, classic man versus woman. You gotta love it, you know? And they going hard at it. They not holding back. They ripping each other a new asshole.
Girls threw bottles at the police. Orders to disperse were ignored. And huge crime was born from the street. Right now, we're trying to destroy
them. This beat is very different. They doing some different shit on here. I want to say it's the Bomb Squad that does Public Enemy stuff. They really kind of showing off and picking some interesting choices to go with these beats. Because, you know, I never really knew what Ice Cube's style was with what theme they created around his image. But I'm really liking it. And Cube, man, he just matched. His energy is so high that he matched the energy of any beat. You could really just throw him on anything and he's an assassin.
Last year alone, there were 452 gang-related murders in the greater Los Angeles area. And let's see if there's anything that can be done about all this.
This is the same song, Endangered Species, from earlier in the album. They just made a remix for it. And then they actually, you know, credit Chuck D for being on it. On the other song, they didn't credit him.
Things are different when you're out with your buddies.
Let's go back to your family.
You know, one thing about Public Enemy production is they always find a way to make their music feel alarming. They always have alarming sounds and things that makes their music feel urgent and alert. Jacking for beats. Yeah, this is dope. He's kind of going to that style again of just, you know, floating on different beats. But now he's really taking niggas' beats, like actual hit songs and shit. He's going right to them and just rapping on them, which I always think is dope. I'm sure this made him even more famous just for, you know, blessing other beats. It's East Coast, West Coast beats. He's all over the place. Very busy beat. A lot going on. A lot of overlaying samples. You know, it's okay. It's a little much for me, though. You know, for my taste, it's like, you're doing a little too much with the sampling. Very unique beat.
Still hear the screams from his mother while my dead in the gut. And it's getting to my temple. Why is that the only time black phones get the body?
Yeah, this goes out to the dead homies. You know, this is a joint you pull the 40 out to. I don't care for this record. But I respect the sentiment of it. We all got dead homies that we miss and love, so it's always good to put it out there. And he just giving up his story about him and his homies who used to, you know, hang out and loke up. And, you know, obviously you live that life, you lose friends. Shit, you lose friends without even living that life. So it goes either way. You just got to be prepared to lose people.
Damn, yo, Sir Z, chill, Daddy D, KD, yo. And the rest of the mobs in the house, yeah. my man, Africa Bambaataa.
He took this record to just give it up to a bunch of forefathers of hip hop, showing love to the African Bambaataa, LL, fucking, of course, Public Enemy. They all over that. They shouting out the Lynch Mob. I even heard Digital Underground, which I got to cover Digital Underground. And see, early hip hop artists always get it. You got to give it up to the forefathers because nobody's style is new and completely uninfluenced. You know, everybody. You know, gets it from somebody, and then you run your direction. You know, you find your in it. Yeah, his first solo album concept and theme. It really just adds up. You know, he's claiming that he's America's most wanted. If you hear this and you see him coming off of NWA, and you know that's niggas with attitude, and they've always showed it. And from all the coverage of them, it adds up. You definitely think that, because they've always gotten in trouble with the government and with the police, and they're always in the news. You know, they ran the news just for mischief and bullshit. And so you would think that he actually is America's most wanted. So that's why he named this album that. The records reflected. They're very grimy street beats. Definitely adds up. It's gangster stories. It's very hood stories, you know. So you get his you get his view on women, you get his view on how he feels about the police, you get his view on how he feels about his blackness. I haven't heard him say anything about being a Muslim on here, but you know, he's definitely militant in his approach. It's not that deep, but it's very truthful, and you can tell. It should be no mystery why he's America's most wanted after listening to this. Artwork, I like it. It tells a story. This is right after him leaving NWA. So he just showing, hey, I still got numbers. I still got a team behind me. I still got people that ride. I'm not out here really solo. You know, it's a lot of people that fuck with me. So I'll go get Public Enemy, and I'll go get the Lynch Mob, and I'll put all these people on this album just to show y'all, fuck y'all. Like downtown LA, he just on the streets mobbing with his guys. Simple, he got that hard ass look, looking like he ready to whoop your ass. But that's Cube all the time, you know. That even Cube movies today, they cast him as a nigga just to whoop ass. Like I said earlier, they really bring a certain urgency to their beats, and from track one, you're kind of just thrown into it, and it doesn't really let you go. It's very different. They bring in a bunch of samples, so I know clearing this motherfucker was a bitch. They took some really dope chances on here and made some interesting canvases. Why it's interesting to see this heavy, like, New York influence on these beats, and the fact that he got Public Enemy to really put their prints all over it said enough. You know, he's like, man, I gotta bring some of that flavor over here. So he did an interesting job of, like, interweaving the East Coast into it and kind of creating a base level West Coast sound. You know, it was some muddiness in there, so I can't get too off the Richter scale with it, but I really did enjoy the production on it, and it made me, you know, have to clue in to certain records more. Very creative, brought in a lot of real life sounds and situations, you know, from hood fights to, you know, powerful statements made by people in the media. Just the way they interweaved a lot of things into it to make you feel a certain way. And that's his music. He always make you feel. And he's super creative. He's super lyrical. And he definitely is going to tell you a story. Very vivid and gangster one. Replay value, we got to go with a 7 on that. You know, he's setting the precedent for it, and anybody who fell in love with gangsta music had to replay this fucking album, because it slaps on here that takes you directions you never heard, and that say the most gangsterish shit you could ever think of. So definitely higher on the replay value for me, so I'll give it a 7. Let me give you 2 records. Got a record called The Bomb. You're gonna enjoy that. It's very different, very explosive. The Bomb, it says it in the name. Check out Gangsta Fairy Tale. I think that's really that's the one for the kids. Back to the Game and the Culture, it's inherently high because He garnished a lot of attention with this project. You know, it's people to this day that I know talk about this project. Because you never heard, you know, something at this scale. For somebody talking like he's talking at that scale. Like, Too Short, he was still, like, just the underground legend. You know, it hadn't reached the masses like N.W.A. did. You know, it didn't reach the masses like Ice Cube did. So for him, this was like he was breaking barriers and fighting wars that were new for hip hop. So for him to stand on his dick and put an album like this out was pretty huge for the culture. Lyrics, it's gangster rap, but Ice Cube is very lyrical. He really is, and he's a stat stuffer, which he's giving you a lot of stuff. He's throwing a lot at you. But then he slows it down a little bit so you can understand. But you got to keep up with him for most of this record. He's saying a lot of things, man. He's just standing on, you know. He touch on the police like we always do because it's so heavy in the black community. You're not gonna hear an album where, you know, them not talking about the police. You know, he's. His style is unmatched. I love to hear his voice. I want to talk like this nigga. He talks so cool and so gangster, and his presence is like dominating. It's just like a Chuck D, but he's his own version. On his lyrics, just because Cube is dope, and he was dumping on a few of these records. I'm going to go with a 9. I'm going to give my man a 9 because he barred up. And we talking 90. Ain't nobody I covered really barred up as hard as he has, really. So, this album scored a 56, which makes it a good album. It's a good album. It's close to being a classic, but not quite there. You know, not quite there. And I think it's because, you know, it's not a whole lot of replay value. I think if it was more songs that you know, that are super classics that we couldn't deny, we would come back. But I think for the artsy-fartsy music dissector, you're going to love to, you know, check out the elements in this album that stick out, because there's a lot of different things that'll stick out to different people for different reasons. So, but it's a good album to listen to. It's eclectic just because you get Ice Cube rapping on East Coast beats, and I never really heard that. The Ice Cube I know is like these super West Coast sounds, super West Coast vibes. So to hear him on his first album away from N.W.A. take a East Coast route was very interesting. Shout out to Ice Cube. Shout out to Public Enemy. Shout out to the Lynch Mob. Anybody that had anything to do with this project. It's a B+. It's a B+ album. I don't think that's a bad grade at all. Cube, you know, I'm definitely gonna listen to more Cube and see what's up. Every day I love you. If don't nobody ever tell you that type of thing. Y'all have a good one. Be safe out here in these crazy streets. And I holler.